Yes.
And this is your charger report.
General Motors since 1951. The stock reached a low of $2.26 a share. This is a result of the decrease in the overall national and world markets. Pontiac, Buick, Cadillac, Hummer, GMC, and Chevrolet are the make and models of the GM company. The 266,000 employees based in 35 countries could take a hit for this recession.
In other news, this week's 24-year-old Joey Chestnut from San Jose, California, broke the pizza eating record, downing 45 slices in 10 minutes this past Sunday to win the famous Famigliola World Pizza Eating Championship. He fasted for more than a day to prepare for this event. Back in 07, he took another title winning Coding Island's 4th of July hot dog eating contest by eating 59 hot dogs in 10 minutes. Last month, he won a contest in Tennessee by eating 93 Crystal hamburgers in 8 minutes.
In other news, gas prices have been on a steady rise until the recent weeks. Gas is now reported at $2.88 a gallon here locally, which beats the price about a month ago of around $3.20. Experts say that the lowering of the gas prices is a direct effect of conservation of oil and gas use in the past 6 months by the U.S. The demand has gone down, and therefore the price is lowering.
This past weekend, a Cambodian couple separated after 40 years of marriage. The husband said that the wife went to him while he was ill, so he moved all his belongings to one side of the house and cut the house into two. This one guy you would not want to make mad. So here's Bob with a very interesting story about Camille Gordon.
There are some kids that might be smart enough to move up a grade. But then there are some kids, well, they just don't have it. And these are some of Bulldeese's finest students.
Hi Bulldeese, I'm Bobby, and I'm going to go around school and see what some students think about other students moving up a grade. Let's go! I'm here with Matt Goody, and I'm going to ask Goody, what do you think about other students moving up a grade?
I don't care.
That's really cool.
It's cool.
They deserve it.
I hope they do if they pass.
What do you think about students moving up a grade?
Yes.
You think you're smart enough to move up a grade?
Yeah.
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 No.
So you want to take the dummy test?
Yeah.
Okay. What's the color of the American flag?
Red, white, and blue.
Red, white, and blue.
Next.
What's the color of American flag?
Red, white, blue.
What's your name?
Matt.
Spell it.
M-A-T-T.
Heather.
Spell it.
H-E-A-T-H-E-R.
Coach Preston.
Spell it.
Friends call me Doug.
Spell it.
Which part?
Doug. Spell it. Spell your name.
D-U-G.
Okay, what's the first question I asked you?
What color is the American flag?
What's the color of the American flag?
What color was the flag?
You missed them all. What? I said, what's the color of the American flag? And you said red, white, and blue. And it's not a color. and it's not a color. Then I said, what's your name? You said, Matt. I said, spell it. I-T. And I said, what's your name? You said, Heather. I said, spell it. I-T. It. Look, I said, spell your name. And then you gotta spell it N-A-M-E. And you spell Doug. And then the first question I asked you is if you want to take a doping test. You need to go down a couple grades. And then the first question I asked you is if you want to take a dummy test. You said the American flag.
So did I pass or not?
No, you failed. Yeah. Hi, booties. So, Camille, I hear that you moved up a grade.
Yes, this year.
Yeah, are you excited about that?
Very.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to see exactly how smart you are. And I'm going to give you the dummy test. You ready to take it?
Sure.
Okay, so what's the color of the American flag?
Red, white, and blue.
Okay. What's your name?
Camille.
Spell it.
C-A-M-I-L-L-E.
Okay, what's the first question I asked you?
Do you want to take the dummy test?
You got one right, but you missed two. And's not a color in the American flag. And I said, spell it. I-T. Some people, huh? I think you should not be a senior this year. I'm here with Miss Atherton. Miss Atherton, what do you think about some students moving up a grade?
Okay, tell me what you mean by moving up a grade, because you have to have so many credits to move from a freshman to a sophomore, and then so many credits to move from a sophomore to a junior.
Well, I know.
Tell me what you mean.
I know a junior that moved up a grade, and she's now a senior.
Has she applied to be an early grad, like to graduate early?
I don't know. You tell me.
Well, we do have students that graduate early because they apply to the board.
Who's in charge of that?
That would be here first, and then they have to send a letter to Mr. Marshall, who's at the board now. And then after they do that, they have to meet a criteria. It has to go before the Board of Education. And then if the board approves it, they can do it.
Yeah, well, I'm smart enough to move up a grade.
I'm
already a senior now.
Who's your counselor?
Okay, don't try to change the subject. Do you think, were you smart enough to move up a grade back in high school?
No, I wasn't. I wanted to hang on to that high school experience as long as I could. Bryan Station graduate.
What? There are many kids in the school that I think are smart enough to move up a grade. And then there are some kids that just don't care. Well, this is Bobby. Later, booties.
Now on to some school news. Leadership is hosting a costume dance November 1st, the day after Halloween. This dance is Sadie Hawkins style, which means the girls ask the guys this time. And if you're as big of a ladies' man as I am, this should be a walk in the park for most of y'all. There will be cheap food, drinks, and even some games. This is going to be a big hit, and tickets will be sold starting Monday during lunch. Each ticket is $3, and that's pretty cheap for 5 hours worth of fun and excitement. Sources say that there will be a costume contest with the winner getting some money. And again, the dance is from 7 to 12 on November 1st.
This year's senior projects are a little bit different. Instead of the technology and visual aid, they've decided to combine them into one. All seniors will present their projects in the spring, and juniors are welcome to too. Here's Chris with the weather.
Hey guys in the studio, this week the weather is it actually feels like we're in the middle of October, with the highs being upper 60s and sunny. Only one day this week we have a chance of rain. But the bad thing about it being so sunny this week is people, they can't park with the sun in their eyes. For example, this guy right here in the Thunderbird, he's parked in two parking spaces. How does that happen? The sun. But hey, you know what? If you feel like the sun, it's going to be a great week. I say, except for Wednesday, 30% chance of rain. But this weekend, beautiful, amazing, no clouds. It's going to be wonderful. I don't need that. This weather, spectacular this week. Just go out, have fun. Overnight low this week is about an average of upper 40s. And it's going to be a great week. Back to you guys.
Well, that's been your charter report for October 20th, 2008.